give you a brief introduction on the paper I will be presenting today. My presentation is based on the paper, as Mapkin have mentioned, based on the paper I presented at the 23rd International Commission on Irrigation Drainage Congress held in Mexico City in November last year. The topic of I am very grateful to Circa for the travel grant they have awarded me, and this enabled me to participate in the international congress. So, to Circa, thank you very much. For the topic of that ICID Congress was on modernizing irrigation and drainage for a new green revolution. So the Congress addressed two questions or issues. First was on the water productivity concept, revisiting the water productivity concepts in light of water, energy, and food nexus. The second question in the addressing the Congress was on the state of irrigation technologies and practicalities in a given socioeconomic context. This second question tackled mainly the adoption of precision irrigation to combat water scarcity by using information and communication technology, remote sensing, control system, and modeling. So, I submitted my paper under this question. At first I felt like the topic of my paper was does not fall well within the concern of that question. But while in my mind, while the use of information and communication technology, satellite data, computer simulation, and automation of irrigation systems is very impressive. I felt that, and I still feel now, that for the given state of our irrigation system in the Philippines, there is a fundamental aspect that needs to be addressed before we can more effectively modernize the irrigation system. So, my presentation today, my presentation today, this afternoon, is about an irrigation modernization strategy, which I think is relevant in the case of national irrigation system in the Philippines, and also would be relevant in similar irrigation system in other countries, especially the ASEAN region. So more often, irrigation system improvement works involve one or some of the components of the irrigation system, either on irrigation structures, flow distribution methods, irrigation efficiency, water productivity, or even the institutional aspect. Also quite often, the interconnectedness of these individual irrigation components is not given due consideration often overlooked in the design of modernization or in the design of improvement works or improvement programs. So, the modernization approach I am advocating is to link the system design to the system operation and to the water supply. More specifically, this modernization approach put emphasis on the coherence among these three aspects: the design of the physical structures of the irrigation, the intended system operation, and the reality of available water supply. So, let me first start this presentation by defining what is irrigation modernization. FAO, the Food and Agriculture Organization of the United Nations, defined irrigation modernization as a process of technical and managerial upgrading of irrigation systems to improve the water delivery service to farms. This definition of irrigation modernization distinguishes itself from the conventional rehabilitation, which simply restores the irrigation structure back to its original design or original form. FAO also put emphasis on irrigation modernization as a process of improving the ability of the system to meet its irrigation demand, and also by providing flexibility to the system to respond to the future needs of the irrigation sector. But based on this definition, we can say that irrigation modernization is not all about the use of high technology and costly automation. So for this presentation, I will briefly discuss some of the key considerations of the of my proposed modernization approach. This include first the system characterization, wherein the overall irrigation system objectives, its operational objectives, and flow control methods employed, as well as the physical capacities of the irrigation structures, will be briefly defined. Second is the is assessing the social acceptability of the introduced irrigation technology or the technology used in the system. Third is the evaluation of the amenability of the existing system to associated irrigation technologies. Fourth is looking at the promising local technology being practiced, especially by farmer irrigators in their irrigation systems. And fifth is the knowing the vision and aspiration of farmer for their modern irrigation system, future modern irrigation systems. And lastly, identifying modernization options for that would be appropriate for the specific case of the systems. And lastly, the concluding remarks for this presentation. So to demonstrate this approach, I took two small canal irrigation systems as my case study systems. They are the Balana River Irrigation System and Santa Maria River Irrigation System. These two systems are gravity type systems built and operated in the 1960s. Each system served about 1,000 hectares of rice areas. The Balana River Irrigation System has a run-of-the-river diversion type dam. It has ungated open outtakes or turnouts. It employs duct build. So this is the municipalities covered by the two systems. The Magdalena for Balana RIS, the Magdalena and the Santa Cruz covers about 100 hectares. Rice areas in Magdalena and Santa Cruz are covered by the Balana River Irrigation System. More than 400 service area, around 400 hectare service areas in Lumban and Pagsanhan is served by the Balana Irrigation System. For the Santa Maria River Irrigation Systems, it covers two municipalities. Around 800, more than 800 hectares in Santa Maria, and more than 100 hectares rice areas of Magutak Laguna. So for the Balana River Irrigation System, it has a run-of-the-river diversion type. Run-of-the-river dam is a dam built across the river to raise the water level and so that we can divert the water into the main canal of the system. The Balana has ungated offtakes, open offtakes or turnouts like this one. It employs duck bill weir, which is shaped like a duck bill, and a long proportional wears like this one. to divide the, or control the flow. It has about 30 kilometer canal network, 87% of which is line. It is an engaged system with no measurement of flows within the irrigation system. It uses natural waterways to convey water out of the service areas. For the Santa Maria irrigation system, it's also a run-of-the-river type dam. It has also a run-of-the-river type diversion dam located in Magdalena. It differs from Balanag RIS in terms of the flow control structures. It has constant head or it has a constant CH or constant head orifice, like this one. Gated offtakes, turnouts, and cross regulator with adjustable vertical gates. Like Balanag, it has about 30 kilometer length canal network, 77% of which is line. It is also an engaged system and uses natural waterways to convey water out of the service area. Balanag and Santa Maria river irrigation system are aimed for productive irrigation, productive rice irrigation during the dry season based on equitable supply per hectare. Productive irrigation means that the irrigation system is designed to provide the water needed for optimum crop growth or optimum yield. The apparent operational objectives of Santa Maria of Balanag River Irrigation System is imposed allocation to tertiary unit by splitted flow and with splitted flow through the main system. Interestingly, it uses a mix of upstream and proportional control for control of water. Imposed allocation means that it is the irrigation agency or the system personnel who has the final say or who decides for the final delivery schedule of water delivery. So the farmer has just to accept it. They have just to agree. So it's imposed allocation. Splitted flow means that the water is divided at the diversion point by means of fixed structures in a predetermined proportion of the incoming flow. So, upstream control is having a target water level in such a way that it corresponds to the desired discharge through the control structures. So that's upstream control of discharge. So that's for Balanag river irrigation system. For Santa Maria, the operational objective is imposed allocation also by imposed allocation to tertiary unit by intermittent flow and with rotational flow through the main system. Intermittent flow is just like setting the gate in either full capacity, fully open, or fully closed. So it's just like turning on and off the switch. So in the canal, you either have the full supply of the water at a full supply level or no water at all. So that's intermittent flow. So rotational irrigation means that the water deliveries to the different canals is by rotation. The different canals, water deliveries to the different canals take turns, as opposed to the simultaneous or continuous flow of water delivery. So both the Balanag and river irrigation, Balanag and Santa Maria river irrigation system have noticeable presence of ungated open offtakes. Usually these are unauthorized or illegal. It's just being made by farmers, constructed by farmers. So they have the noticeable presence of these open turnouts. So okay, so when we see when we talk about the design coherence, we can say that the splitted flow of Balatak is not consistent with the productive irrigation objective of the system. The presence of direct offtakes or turnout is not consistent with the rotational flow objective. And the run of the river pipe dams of the two systems would not support well the productive irrigation objective of the two systems. So with this system characteristic, we can say that the present state of irrigation of the Balanac and Santa Maria River irrigation system is not coherent. Its design objective is not coherent with its operational objectives, and not coherent with its physical features. After checking on the coherence of system design with respect to its objective, it is also equally important to check on the physical capacity of the irrigation structure to perform its various functions that are related to system operation. These functions are listed along the horizontal axis, the division, storage, maintenance, sediment control, discharge transfer. Discharge transfer is like if you set the gate at certain point, maybe upstream of the canal network, you set it, say, low, higher, you get a bigger opening. Discharge transfer is about looking at how long this change in the opening of the gates will be felt at the downstream portion. So that's the discharge transfer. The rest of the function, I think you are quite familiar with: flow measurement, communication between the one who gives the command to open or close the gate, and to the one who is actually doing the physical work. So transport or access, if the operation staff can actually go there and supervise the water distribution, and the diversion of water and the storage functions of the dam. So these functions of the irrigation system is defined in an FAO spouse methodology for planning for irrigation system modernization. For this case study, the relative capacity of the irrigation system for these different functions were evaluated. The actual capacity versus the design capacity, and the design capacity versus the need or the required capacity were compared. So, this is the. Oh, sorry, let me just go back. So, in. The main consideration in assessing this capacity function is looking at the irrigation structure or the system and asking whether the system would be capable of whether the system has the appropriate structures, has enough number of appropriate structure, the structure are of sufficient capacity or sufficient features so that the system is capable of performing this function. So that's basically the question that we consider when we assess these relative capacities. So the lower the irrigation structure has a lower capacity values would mean that they are either poorly they either have deteriorated, is poorly constructed, or have the outdated system capacity. So this is the result of the capacity assessment for Balana system. You can see that most of the functions have a lower capacity values, except for the communication function. This is due to the use of cell phones by system officials and their beach standard. So for Santa Maria, basically it improved. Right? It's a little bit better than the Balana River irrigation system, but still there's a big room for improvement. So communication is also the one with the high capacity values. So for the two systems, the most telling capacity issues is are the diversion capacity and storage capacity of their dams. You would recall that their dams is just a run-of-the-river diversion. So basically, inherently, run-of-the-river diversion dam doesn't really have storage capacity. And the diversion capacity was compromised because of heavy siltation at the dams. For the Balana, another telling issue is the division capacity of the canal network, because most of their irrigation structures were vandalized. As many will agree, it is also equally important to check on the social acceptability of the irrigation technology that were used in the system. So social order is one of the primary internal indicators in the rapid appraisal procedure, or RAP, a diagnostic tool being spoused by the FAO and the international irrigation community in assessing the acceptability of the irrigation system, of the technology. So you can see that in this figure, the sub-indicators in RAP, let me just explain, in the rapid appraisal procedure, the indicators are assigned the values ranging from 0 to 4, with 0 denoting least desirable and 4 as most desirable. So you can see in this figure that the sub-indicators for social order have values which are generally lower, ranging from 0 to 2. So we can say that these low values for social order indicator suggest the lower level of satisfaction by the farmers with their irrigation system. Alternate wetting and drying method is a water saving technique initiated by the International Rice Research Institute. This method was field demonstrated in selected national irrigation systems in the country. The field demonstration was an effort by the government to convince upstream farmers not to over irrigate or free up the water for the downstream farms. However, in the case of the Balana River irrigation system, AWD was not adopted. The main issue is that they don't really have a functioning flow control structure along the main conveyance canal. So the implementation, successful implementation of on-farm water saving technology, on-farm water management, would not be possible without functioning flow control structures along the main conveyance canal. Planning for irrigation modernization can take a hint from the initiative of the locals, farmer irrigators of the system. The Irrigators Association of Balana and Santa Maria RIS have initiated water reuse and water supply augmentation by constructing check to recapture the drainage of water from upstream farms, and by constructing simple basin or tanks to impound or store the spring water in their nearby areas. Also, in the case of Balana River irrigation system, the downstream farmers pump irrigation groundwater to supplement their canal supply during the dry season. So this local initiative in trying to address the limited water supply points to a potential irrigation technology that can be adapted for irrigation system modernization. The national irrigation system, or most of the national irrigation system in the Philippines, in our country, are under the Irrigation Management Transfer Contract, or IMT contracts, with the Irrigators Association gradually taking over the operation and management of the system. Thus, it is important that the farmers' visions and aspirations are embodied in the modernization plan that the NIA is doing for formulating for the NIS. While the farmers knows exactly what the quality of irrigation service they desire or aspire for, the corresponding irrigation technology and its implication on the system operation might not be fully understood by many of the farmers. So if there would be a lack of consensus on the proper irrigation technology, this would result in farmers' dissatisfaction and vandalism of the control structures. So these are the identified modernization options for the two systems. Basically, they involve either change or improvement in the system management, or either involve civil works, or a combination of the two. So these options can be prioritized based on their impacts on improving the irrigation service, which is the main purpose of irrigation modernization, and also on the available funds. So for the concluding remarks, let me just read through this. Logical coherence among the system design, operation, and water supply is a crucial consideration in planning for system irrigation system modernization. On-farm water management or water-saving techniques require flow control structure along the main conveyance canal. Technology options and their implications on system operation need to be well understood by the stakeholders of the irrigation system, which are mostly the farmers. So that ends my presentation. Thank you very much for your attention.